Yo!
Yo! What's up? I'm Adam.
I'm Alex.
And Alex is joining us again. You spent some time with Patrick going through, like, what can you do without Copilot? But look, I'm the pilot. And so show me what Copilot can do that I can't.
Well, Adam, then let's go ahead and start out in the modern Power Query editor here. Absolutely love it, especially in the home tab here. We now notice in the far right-hand side, we've got that amazing Copilot button. So let's go ahead and open this up now. And I'm going to type in one of my favorite prompts here. I'm just going to go ahead and say, just only keep the customers when the country is equal to the USA. Let's go ahead and hit submit.
It's like I'm having a conversation with my data.
Bananas. Let us know in the comments what you think about today's video. That was incredible.
No, there's got to be more, Alex. There's got to be more.
So you're a little skeptical is what I'm hearing. You're saying, you know, I saw that you applied a filter. I could have clicked the button. Anyone could have done
Look,
that.
Patrick could have done that.
Hashtag Patrick could have done that.
Yeah.
Since you're a little skeptical, let's try and do the count, total number of customers by the state and kind of only keep the top three by the largest size. Submitting this now, letting Copilot kind of think about it. So Adam, last time we just did one step at a time, but this time we actually chained multiple together. That would have taken us one button spinny wheel, two button spinny wheel, three button spinny wheel.
But there's got to be more.
All right. So still a little skeptical here. You're like,
I need more.
Yeah. I'm thinking about the creativity of Copilot. I've noticed the guy in a cube videos, they're just getting a little stale here. So I'm going to ask it for a little bit of help. Maybe titles inspired by Star Wars. Let's see what we can do as maybe a title for this video.
Ooh, I like this.
Awesome. So we've got a Power BI, A New Hope, The Empire Strikes Back, Dax, Phantom of the Data Menace. Oh, that one's pretty good.
The force is strong with Copilot. I will give it that. Is that it? Or is that the power of Copilot?
All right. So you've seen us do some simple stuff, some chained activities. Now a little bit of creativity. Like let's really combine all this stuff together. Adam, we always get called in to looking at people's data models. We're always like, where's your data table? Where's your data table? Wouldn't it be great if we just ask Copilot to build that for us? So in this example, we're going to ask it to go ahead and just create a new calendar table starting from 2017 to the current date. Just include tons of columns to slice and dice our data to buy. That was crazy. Look how long the scroll bar is, top to bottom.
Look at all those steps.
Oh my gosh.
Bring up the M script on that.
Wow.
Oh. Now we're at Chris Webb's level. That's a lot.
That is a lot. We did the simple stuff. We did the complex stuff. We did some creative stuff. And we did something like this where a difficult problem that a lot of people have kind of stated, go build calendars, go do this.
Yeah.
Throw it into Copilot, let it do 50 plus steps. Adam, I do have one more trick though on this one, if you don't mind.
All right, let's see.
All right. It's not only added the steps for us, but I'd like to have a little bit more information about, what were you actually doing here? So I'm just going to ask Copilot to kind of describe the query itself. Awesome. So here Copilot has now written all these descriptions. I'm going to go to the very top here. So Adam, it says the query generates a comprehensive date table from January 1st to the current date. Yes, that's exactly what I was kind of looking for. It goes through and describes each line by line step here.
This is nice because now I've just got to copy and paste it. And then I've got my documentation, right?
I mean, that would be pretty good, but I think we can do much better, right?
Okay.
So if we were to go to the bottom of the description here, we have this add to query where it says, I'll go and inject the descriptions for you. It says, hey, I noticed you had a few descriptions already. Is it okay to overwrite? Absolutely. Yeah. Let's go ahead and do that. These are much better. Top to bottom.
Wow.
All of these have now been described. If we hover above the query, also the query level description has been added.
Added bananas. All right. Everyone should be doing that. Well, I mean, is there anything else Copilot can do? I mean, this is a lot.
So we've seen a lot here. Let's go back to the very beginning because I know you were a little skeptical here at the top. So I'm going to go into my query. We're going to just go back to kind of that early example, right? Especially if you're a newer inexperienced user, Adam, you've never seen Power Query before. It's got all these amazing buttons. You're just like, well, which ones do I press? But you know the problem you want to solve, right? So we're going to ask it to just go ahead and only keep married customers. Very simple. And again, we see on the card, it has the icon here for the filter rows. If we were to hover above this now, obviously we can see, all right, I'm starting to learn the UI as I go. We didn't give it precisely which column to use or even that there was a key here. So marital status, M equals married, S equals single. Yep. Copilot was able to figure that out.
You may need to validate that, right? Because it may not get it just right. But in this case, it got it spot on.
And of course, if there's an error, you can undo it here on the card. You can delete it from the applied steps list. Yep. Let's go and try it, kind of another one here as well. Maybe creating new columns by the login, kind of a username and company. If we go to the right-hand side, it added two new columns, username and company, just kind of based upon the original column here. So if we were to go back, email address. Well, I would need to know what a slip by is. I would need to know what a delimiter is. I would need to know what the at symbol is. but in this example, again, I knew my problem and Copilot figured it out for me.
Yeah.
All right, so let's try another one here then. I'm going to do a little bit more complex. Keep the rows where the education is bachelor's, occupation is professional, and the title is Mrs. So I think about this, Adam, whenever you and me are kind of chatting on Teams or you forward me an email and saying, I'm way too busy, just go do all these things for me on the list, right? Just copying and pasting.
It's a lot of steps.
Huge. A new filter rose. But most importantly, Adam, if we click on this settings, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. It just saved us 11 clicks.
I'm going to say Copilot is the new click tax remover.
Oh, I love it. So I love these examples again, where you have to think, is it the and or the or condition? You have to go through each field well and find the right column. It's making me more productive, even as a professional user, to be like, is that something I want to fuss with, or can I just outsource it to Copilot? I'm going to go to this query here now. You know, we always see like a lot of these just very horizontal laid out tables where it's like, oh my gosh, is it the pivot? Is it the unpivot? You have to do it once or twice until you kind of only remember the one. But wouldn't it be better if we just ask Copilot here to just do multiple steps here? So turning rows into kind of columns, casting data types, and also just ensuring that it's also like a ascending order here at the very end. Awesome. So Adam, once again, I was able to figure this out. We chained multiple prompts together. More importantly, though, we were a little bit of chaos because we used a numbered list, we used a dash, and then we kind of gave it these mixed words like DSC, which only makes sense if you're kind of a SQL background.
So it can handle the chaos. That is Alex. That's good to know.
Yes.
That's good to know.
So let's go ahead and do another one here. Then I'm going to go to my product table. And a lot of these tables, Adam, I look at in models, they just bring in every column and they kind of say, hey, we'll clean it up after the fact.
The business said they needed all of it.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
I only need this one column product key. Instead of like scanning left and right and hoping I got them all, I'm just going to ask Copilot, just only keep the product key in my table, but dynamically remove every other column as a suffix of key, ID, or label. Okay. Let's go ahead and submit that.
Oh, I like that.
So it's not just the data that we're kind of using Copilot with, but it could also be the schema.
You know, when Patrick and I would do demos before, and it was like, oh, I got to remove all the keys and I got to go through each one. And there's a bunch of them on the fact table. So I'm like, oh, this is nice.
So in this example, choose columns. It wrote this dynamic formula now for us. So it has the ends with key, ID, or label. So now in the future, if any new columns get added to the table, we don't have to worry about them. We are only keeping the actual columns that we want.
Nice.
Last one. When we were connecting out to the databases, I always see these capitalized names. Everyone's always yelling at us, capital store underscore key. And I don't get any joy from this activity, Adam. I don't, you know, log off for the day and tell the spouse and family that I renamed 200 columns. You should have seen me, right? Like, this is the perfect job for a Copilot.
What did you
do? Let's ask him to change all the column names to be more readable using proper case, removing any underscores. So we're going to submit this now. We saw in the last example where Copilot was able to kind of move some columns and drop them. We're going to ask it to just do a complete custom function here now for us, where it renamed every single column in our table to be more readable.
I think you convinced me. Copilot can do a lot of cool things for me. It's not that it's replacing what I do, but it's making me go faster so I can move on to the things that really are meaningful.
So that's big for me, is just the inexperienced user using it to learn Power Query, and then the advanced users being, okay, how can I be even faster in my development time? Like that big calendar table with that massive advanced editor screen.
Yeah.
That would have taken us hours to write, even as a professional.
It's not that we're lazy, we're just efficient. Let us know down in the comments if you have any questions for Alex or myself on Copilot, and specifically on Power Query Copilot. Would love to hear your thoughts on it. Are you using it? Have you gotten a lot of good experiences with it? As always, from both Martha, Patrick, Alex, and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.